Independence. Today is Friday, February the 6th, and here are your morning announcements. Attention all drama club members. Please plan to stay after school on Tuesday, February the 10th, to take a group picture for the yearbook. The math problem of the week can be found in any math classroom. Please turn your answers into Ms. Clark in D223. Makeup club pictures for the yearbook will be on Tuesday, February the 10th, after school. Please make plans to stay after on that day if you are interested in having your club picture be in the yearbook. Baseball tryouts are Monday, February the 9th at 3 o'clock. You must have an updated physical to try out. See Coach Moore if you have any questions. Now for a message to you seniors. Seniors, tonight is your night. Mu Alpha Theta will meet Wednesday, February the 11th at 7 o'clock in D223. All members are asked to bring a bag of chips for the Interscholastic Math League March Contest. And now, Mario and Luigi would like to tell you about a fundraiser for the Science National Honor Society.
So who should we ask first? Let's just ask all of them.
Okay.
Hey, would you be coming? Only get picture if you will be coming.
Sure, whatever.
We'll do it in town.
Yeah!
Thank you, are you going to be going to the video game tournament?
I didn't know there was a video game tournament.
but we want you at the video game tournament.
It's okay, we'll walk it too. Would you like to go to the video game tournament next Friday, the 13th?
Me and Mario will be there.
Are you gonna be at the video game tournament?
Oh.
So hard for Luigi.
I get up. He will come. But I want them to go to the game tournament.
I just told you he will come.
Yeah.
We'll let you hit the break. You maybe get money.
A mushroom.
Maybe even one up. Of course you do, everyone.
But
I like Mario games.
I like Luigi.
Yes! Did you hear that? Someone like my game!
You had a game?
Yes, Luigi's Mansion!
I thought you were just cleaning at the house.
So, who are you?
I'm...
Who is he?
I'm a Mario.
Said that like you weren't sure.
Huh? I'm a Mario.
So who are you?
I'm a Luigi.
But I thought today was twin day. So it seems like both of y'all should be either Luigi or Mario.
Please answer the question.
Something to think about.
Oh my god.
Hello. Will any of you be coming to video game competition next Friday?
I would love to.
So we'll see you guys there next Friday?
I will definitely see you.
You definitely should. He's the best character.
Is he?
Yeah. Luigi.
What about the Luigi? He's player two.
Actually,
we have a question to ask you.
Oh my goodness. Hey, hi.
Oh, you'll be at the tournament.
I have fun.
Oh, but bring them to tournament.
Aww.
They all have fun.
So you guys are going to be at the video game tournament?
Yeah!
Alright!
Remember, it's only $5 on Friday the 13th. The IHS Forensics team went to Memphis this past weekend for a tournament at Collierville High School. The team won second place Saturday and placed only 1 point behind the first team, 115-116. There were 20 schools competing from across the state of Tennessee. Many IHS Forensics team members advanced to finals and were awarded trophies at the awards ceremony. John Castro, first place in prose interpretation. Mary Glenn Miller, first place in impromptu speaking. Natalie Scalar and Kristen Dominguez, first place in duet acting. Diane Perry, first place in storytelling, second year in a row as tournament champion. Chelsea Leroy, second place in storytelling. Patrick Norwood and Audra Mathis, third place in duet acting. Natalie Scalar, third place in poetry interpretation. Sierra Faith, fifth place in original oratory. Emily Sloan and Shariah Baker, sixth place in duo improvisational acting. Now, let's hear from Pittman on sports.
They say family that plays together, stays together. And one that walks apart, just falls apart. So, together we stay.
This is 9 p.m. with this week's sports news. This is coming home week. And tonight, the Indy Varsity Basketball teams will host Hero Wood. Game times are 6 p.m. and 7:30 p.m. All in the Instant Fans Theater. Today and tomorrow, our wrestling team will go to Clarksville for the state duels. Good night, guys. This has been Pittman on Sports. Go Eagles. Back to two, Cody.
Thanks, Ryan. There's a short German club meeting after school on Monday at 2:45 in Mr. Hemmerich's room, B120. And here's Kevin Wood with some reasons why you should buy coming home tickets.
Hey, IHS, this is Kevin Wood, and I'm here to give you 5 reasons on why you should come to tonight's coming home dance. Let's get down to business. Number 1, it's something to do after the game. I don't know what you guys do in the weekends. Play WoW? Or just go home, hang out with friends, who knows? But why not come to a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for you seniors and a once-in-every-4 years opportunity for you freshmen? It's called Coming Home, and it's gonna be awesome. Which leads me to my second reason. Number 2, it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be awesome. It's gonna be joyful. I don't know, have you ever been to a dance? Maybe not, maybe so. Either way, tonight is not to be missed. Number three, you get to hang out with your friends in an awesome, positive environment. I don't know about you, but to me, that sounds like a Lollapalooza of fun. Number four, a dance. A dance. Enough said. Number five, you can find a new romantic interest. For those of you shy guys walking around the halls, or you outgoing girls who just can't find true love, maybe tonight's your night. Maybe you'll find that awesome dance partner you've been looking for friends or for love. I don't know, which leads me to the matchmaker's conclusion. If you don't have a date, you can pick up a matchmaker in the commons right now. Right now you can do that. It's awesome because they match you with 10 people and they match you in the same grade and they match you with 10 people in the other grade and there's like 10 people that you probably should stay away from because you might not get along. You never know, it's awesome. You never know. Number six or five or either or, doesn't matter. It's a superhero themed dance. It's a superhero themed dance. Thank you for your time. I'm Kevin Wood. Back to you, Cody.
The dance is directly after the game. Tickets are $5 and the dance ends at 11:30. Track practice officially begins Monday, February the 9th. If any athlete expects to participate in track this year and is currently in another sport, they need to come by and talk to Coach Finley in A204. Otherwise, everyone in track is required to be at practice daily beginning Monday unless they specifically clear it with their head coach. Now, let's see the first segment of our newest spot.
Jess, this is Coach Jones for the first edition of Coach's Corner. Today we're outside of Coach Stephanie Pruitt, the head volleyball coach's classroom, and we're going to go inside, we're going to visit her and talk to her about this year's state championship. I'm sitting here with Sam Surley, Grace Pirelli, and Caroline Carlton. They're going to join me in this adventure. Let's go. Coach Pruitt! Coach Pruitt! Coach Pruitt, can we have a few minutes with you? This is Coach Stephanie Pruitt. And Coach, first of all, I want to congratulate you on a great season this year and a tremendous magical season and a great accomplishment for the state championship. So we brought you some flowers here.
Thanks.
And we want the school to know who you are and about the Independence High School volleyball team and what a magical season they had. Coach, you mind answering a few questions for us?
Sure.
All right, Coach. I remember coming to IHS, and the first week I came, you had your tryouts. I didn't know anything about IHS volleyball. Going into the season, and this being your first year, what were your expectations for the season?
Well, this is my fourth year, actually. My expectations for the season, I think that we really just kind of set our sights first on districts, on winning the district championship, because that's never been done before in IHS history. And I think after we started winning more of our regular season games, we kind of started focusing on postseason and regionals and finally making it to state.
All right, good deal. Yes, it is your fourth season. That's what I meant to say, your fourth season. Now, Coach, I know that all seasons have valleys and peaks, and this one I'm sure was no different, even though it was a magical season. Coach, what was the hardest thing about this season that you had to face as a coach?
The beginning of our season was a little tough, trying to figure out who was going to play our opposite middle hitter from Sam. And I kind of had the idea that Caroline would do a good job. So we threw her in at camp, and she proved me right, thankfully. And then after that, once Sam got hurt with her high ankle sprain injury, that kind of made me a little concerned about our potential block. And Kristen Johnson stepped up in Sam's place and did an awesome job along with Caroline, making the block still extremely large. And then I was really worried about our first week of district play because we had Father Ryan, Brentwood, and Centennial all in the same week, and I was worried that the girls wouldn't necessarily be ready because we had to make such a quick change after Sam hurt herself. And they went into that Father Ryan game so pumped up. It was an amazing game, and that kind of proved to them that they could do it and go on until we were able to get our full team back. And so the Father Ryan game was really a big turning point for us.
Excellent, Coach. Now, I know that this is your first senior class to come through, and I don't want to make you cry. I'm sure it's very, very emotional, and they mean a lot to you. But could you say something about this senior class and what they mean to you?
They're a very special class. It's my first one, obviously, so they're always going to have a special place in my heart. It just so happened that this was the group that, you know, they've been talking for 4 years about going to state, and they truly made it happen. I mean, they work so hard. They're extremely competitive. They're extremely talented. You know, I've got a couple girls who are already going to be signed with colleges, so that just kind of proves even more that these girls deserve the state championship, and they really earned it and worked hard for it, their careers.
Excellent, excellent. Now, this was such a magical season. I can only imagine what was going through your mind when you were in Murfreesboro and you were sitting on the bench and you were thinking, oh my gosh, you know, we're about to win the state championship. Coach, take us through that moment when you realized that you were about to win the state championship over Brentwood.
Okay, well, let me take you to another moment that I really like, too.
Okay.
We're in the semifinal match, and we were playing Red Bank, and the crowd was behind us, and they started chanting, "We want Brentwood." I think that's when I finally realized that, like, we're going to win semis, and then we're going to go play Brentwood in the finals. And I could hear the Brentwood girls on the bench laughing about it, and I was like, oh, yeah, it's going to happen. And then that morning I woke up before we played, and I was like, it's going to be Brentwood. It's going to be us and them in the finals. And then when we finally got to that point in the fourth game, and it was the last ball, and I remember I think we put it outside, and the ball didn't go down, and then we were all screaming on the bench going, give it to Tess, give it to Tess. And then she went up and put the ball away, and that was it. It was awesome. I mean, I just kind of sat there for the last couple points and was just like, this is it. This is what it feels like, and it was awesome.
Well, that is amazing, and it was an amazing season. And again, we want to congratulate you. Now, I brought these three girls in here because they're going to say a few things about what you mean to them and what you've done for them in their life.
I've got post-it notes from Caroline.
Sam, would you speak first for us?
You've really been, like, a good friend to us, not only our coach, but a good friend. And you mean so much to us, and we're going to miss you so much next year when we're gone. And it's just, like, been the best 4 years, having you as a coach. Like, it's just been awesome.
Grace?
You're definitely my favorite coach I've ever had, like, by far, hands down. And you had, like, a lot of faith in all of us. And I know, like, since I was, like, short for my position, you still had faith in me, and that meant a lot.
Caroline?
You're real nice.
Impressive, Caroline.
No, I should keep going. I like you as a coach a lot. You were fun, and, like, you made me be middle, and I was really upset about it, but you made me do it, and then I loved it, and now that's all I want to play. Thank you, and it's awesome.
Coach, I want to thank you for joining us for this first edition. And IHS, I want to thank you guys for joining us for this first edition. If you don't know who this is Coach Stephanie Pruitt. She's the head volleyball coach here at Independence High School, and we are very proud of her and her team's accomplishments. It was a great season. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time here on IHS Coach's Corner.
Thanks, Coach Jones. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Yes, Independence sweethearts and lovers, it's that time of year again when the matchmaker surveys have returned. Results will be on sale during lunch this week and next for the low, low price of $2. Dance tickets are now on sale during lunch for the pre-sale price of $5. There will be $7 at the door. The dance will begin immediately following the boys' basketball game and end at 11:30. Our theme is superheroes and dress is casual. SkillsUSA will have a meeting next Wednesday, February the 11th, from 2:45 to 3:15 in Mr. Pruitt's room. Please plan to attend. And remember that the deadline to purchase your club t-shirt is this Friday the 6th, so bring in $11 to Mr. Pickerel or your career and tech teacher ASAP. Softball tryouts will take place next Monday and Tuesday after school from 3 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. All girls are required to have an updated physical in order to try out. See Coach Jay in room D112 if you have any questions. National Technical Honor Society will have a meeting this coming Monday, February the 9th, at 2:45 p.m. in the library. Don't forget to bring $11 for t-shirts. We hope to see you there. Friday, February the 13th, Independence is hosting a special needs Valentine's Ball. As students, you are encouraged to come by during your lunch and study hall. It will be counted as an in-school field trip, so you have to fill out a form. Tennis begins next week. Boys' tryouts are on Monday, and girls' tryouts will be on Tuesday. You must have a completed physical to participate. If you are in a winter sport and interested in tennis, please see Coach Balzer as soon as you can. The following PBS winners need to pick up their basketball tickets for tonight's game in Mrs. Oyer Johnson's office: Josh Valdez, Ricine Ellison, and Chris Lepore. Now, let's hear from Ryan Pigg.
The balcony, a haven for seniors. They've given out these bracelets for all seniors now. So whether you're on the balcony or the library, they will have to check you for you to stay there. Whether you're a girlfriend, a boyfriend, a best friend, a brother, or a sister, if you're an underclassman, not a senior, and on the balcony, you're not welcome.
Remember, only seniors are allowed on the balcony. Thanks, IHS, and have a great day.